certainly an honor and a privilege to stand before you this morning and to be able to proclaim the name and the goodness of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I give honor to our pastor, the Reverend Dr. Melvin O. Mariner, for this opportunity to be able to stand before you all. Even though it is virtually, I'm glad that we can connect in the spirit and be on one accord and lift up his name. Amen. There is a word from the Lord this morning. I feel like preaching this morning, and I'm excited about it. So if you can, we're going to turn to Acts chapter 3, starting at verse 1. I know you're at home with your bonnets and your do-rags on, but if you can, just change your positioning and stand for me wherever you are. And we're going to turn to Acts chapter 3, verse 1. Very familiar passage of scripture. Talks about Peter healing a lame beggar. It says, one day, Peter and John were going up to the temple at the time of prayer at 3 p.m. Now a man who was lame from birth was being carried to the temple gate called Beautiful, where he was put every day to beg from those going into the temple courts. When he saw Peter and John about to enter, he asked them for money. Peter looked straight at him, as did John. Then Peter said, "Look at us." So the man gave them his attention, expecting to get something from them. Then Peter said, "Silver or gold I do not have, but what I do have, I give you." He says, "In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, walk." In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, walk. If I can put a topic on this text this morning, it would be, I'm getting on my feet. I'm getting on my feet. Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight. You may be seated in Jesus' name. For the last several weeks, my pastor has been talking about having critical conversations and dealing with the topic identity crisis. And when we deal with our identity and who we are in Christ, I found that one of the main things that scripture talks about connected to that is freedom. Freedom to live and to enjoy a life full of abundance and spiritual wealth. And one of the greatest threats to that freedom is cycles of dysfunction. Dysfunction meaning abnormal or impaired. So one of the greatest threats to your Christian liberty, saints of God, is the reality that you could be ensnared in a cycle of dysfunction. And as a result, missing out on the fullness of what God has for your life. And so this morning, it is my divine assignment to deal with and to speak to the cycles of dysfunction that we find ourselves in. Because the reality is that it does not matter who you are or how saved you think you are or where you come from. It doesn't even matter what your socioeconomic status is. As long as you are in this mortal flesh, as long as you are considered human and walking around on this earth, we will all have some stuff that we have to deal with. That goes for you. That goes for your mama. That goes for your daddy. It even goes for your sanctified grandmother because she might have some stuff with her too. It does not matter who you are. We all have some stuff we need to address in this life. In case you didn't know, it is not the will of God for you to be entangled in cycles of dysfunction. And I can say with a certainty that it is a trick of the enemy. Because anytime you find yourself trapped in any form of routine dysfunction or routine bondage, you are living a life that is beneath the privilege that was afforded to you through the sacrifice on Calvary's cross. This is why it is recorded plainly in the scripture that if any man be in Christ, it said he is a new creature. He said all things are passed away, and behold, look, all things have been made new. because you have been connected to Christ, you now have the power to break out of cycles of dysfunction. Hear me. Break free of strongholds of oppression and to break and destroy every yoke of bondage in your life. I wish I can get a few people just to type in the comments, break the cycle, break the cycle, break the cycle. And so this morning, our pericope of scripture in Acts 3 and 1, Luke introduces us to a nameless man that has some type of deformity in his legs that's preventing him from being able to walk. He says that two of the apostles, Peter and John, were on their way into the temple at the hour of prayer. And he says that there was a certain man who was lame from birth. The text goes on to say that this man was carried to the gates of the temple. If I could tell the story, it said he was carried every day just so he could lay there and ask for donations. Now, right about here is where I like to start asking some critical questions because this man was lame from the time he left his mother's womb. So one could suggest that this man was born into dysfunction. And remember, we define dysfunction as abnormal or impaired. And the text says that because of his condition, people laid him at the gate to beg every day. So not only was he born into dysfunction, but he went through the same cycle of dysfunction every day of his life. Now, the first critical question I had to ask myself when reading this text is, if the people had to lay him at the gate every day doing the same thing, wasn't there anything else those people could have done to help better his quality of life? I mean, this isn't the first time in the Bible where a group of BFFs, a group of pals, carried a lame friend. It was just a few books ago in the Gospels when a lame man had friends so committed to them that they tore a hole in somebody's roof just to get them to Jesus. So what in the world makes me wonder why this particular group of friends didn't do more to help this lame man here in Acts chapter 3? Because think about it, every day these people had to pick this man up from where he lives. If I could paint the picture for you, they had to carry him all the way to the gates of the temple. They laid him there so he could beg and ask for money, and then they went on about their business. I said the people had to pick him up from where he lived. They had to walk him all the way to the gates of the temple just so he could lay there and ask for money, and they went on about their business. I'll say it one more time just for the people who just logged on. I said the people had to pick him up every single day of his life. They had to carry him all the way to the entrance of the temple. They had to lay him there as if he was some type of object just so he could beg for money, and then they went on about their business. And here's the revelation. The Lord told me to tell 100 of you watching, you ought to be leery of so-called friends in your life that are okay with you being stagnant while they're still moving. I said you ought to be leery of people in your life that are okay with you being stagnant while they're still moving. Because the fact of the matter is, if they are true friends, they wouldn't be satisfied with you being stuck in your dysfunction. I'd like to suggest to you, saints of God, that it is never a good season in your life for anyone in your circle to aid you in your cycle of bondage. And every once in a while, you have to do what I like to call a circle check, because you need some folk in your life that won't leave you wallowing in your mess. You need some people that won't agree with everything you say, Lenny Shelley. Some people that will say, baby, I know it's hard and I know it's rough and I know life has thrown you some bad cards, but you've been laying down long enough. You've been living beneath your potential for long enough, and it's time to get on your feet. Somebody ought to type, get on your feet, get on your feet. And so the people picked him up and they carried him and they laid him at the gate every day so that he could beg and ask for money. They might get me later for exegeting the text, but I'm going to say this anyway because here it is. They carried him every day just so he could lay there and beg for money. And the question is asked, wouldn't they have got tired of carrying the man?
But here's the revelation. Some people don't mind carrying your weight because they love the fact that you need them in order to survive. I'll say it again. I said, some people don't mind carrying your weight because they love the fact that you need them in order to survive. They love the fact that you need them to carry you because it puts you beneath them. But I came to do a wake-up call for 100 of you this morning that while you're sitting at home in your house robe, this is your season to get on your feet because breakthrough is on the way. Somebody ought to shout breakthrough. One of the most scary attributes of being in cycles of bondage is the fact that you can be in them so long that normal becomes foreign. And listen to this, the stench of dysfunction becomes your perfume. I said the stench of dysfunction can become your perfume. That means you like it, you start to love it. It starts to become normal and routine. This man was lame from birth. It means he had never walked before. He had never experienced walking. So all he knew was being in a lifestyle of being a beggar. This is what he's always done. That's the way he's always done it. But let me tell you something. Just because that's the way it's always been done doesn't make it right. And it doesn't mean that it always has to stay that way. Your season of change is here today. Every day this man would lay at the entrance of the temple and the people would pass him by. Life would pass him by and he would just lay there. People would talk and go by him and he would just lay there. Things were happening all around him and yet and still he's just laying there. And just the other day, the Lord told me, he said, Jamie, for too long now, my people have just been laying there. My church has just been laying there. People have been dying on the streets, and we've just been laying there. Folks have gone through life without proper health care and food to eat, and we've just been laying there. People have gone through life feeling unloved and unwanted, and we've just been laying there. Social injustice happening in our own backyards, and we've just been laying there. Your own children in your own household have been caught up in generational cycles that should have stopped with you, but you've just been laying there, stuck in your own routine, laying there, stuck in your own cycle, laying there, stuck in your own dysfunction, laying there. But I came to declare as a prophet of God that the hour of deliverance is here. This is your season that every yoke of bondage, every generational curse, and every demonic contract on your life has been dismantled and destroyed in the name of Jesus. So the text says, and I'm almost done, that as this man is doing what he always does, he's laying at the gate and he's begging for money. And it says that two of Jesus' homeboys, former homeboys, they roll up on the scene and he looks at Peter and John and he asks them for money. Doing what he always does because he's always been this way and nothing is ever going to change. And let me tell you something, if you do what you've always done, you're going to get what you've always gotten. But if you want to get something different, if you want to get something new, you need to start expecting something different. You need to do something different. This man was in the presence of men who carried the anointing of God. And he still decided to ask for money. This man is at a gate called Beautiful, begging for money. This man is in a beautiful place with an ugly situation. Didn't even realize that he had the opportunity staring him right in the face to be healed. And the revelation is this, that cycles of bondage and dysfunction can cause you to have low expectations. And some of us, thanks to God, are guilty of having mediocre expectations while being connected to a mighty God. I said some of us are guilty of having mediocre expectations while connected to a mighty God. But I'm here to tell you, in the words of our pastor, Dr. Melvin O'Manner, you can never rise to low expectations. But if you have the faith to expect it, God has the power to perform it. I said, if you have the faith to expect it, God has the power to perform it. It's my last point, and again, we're going home. So you can imagine Peter and John walking and having this man stop their daily routine of going to the temple for prayer. And this man asking them for money. And Peter looked at the man, as did John, the scripture said, and he says, "Look at us." The man looked at them, said he set his affections, attention on them. And Peter says, "I don't have any money." Some versions say, "I don't have any silver, nor do I have any gold." And in other words, he says, "I don't have anything to give you that will allow you to remain in your cycle of bondage. But what I do have, I feel like preaching now, I'll give it to you in the name of Jesus Christ." He said, "Rise up and walk." And now right about here, we can shout for just about 2 minutes virtually, and then we can log on off, because Peter could have just said, "I don't have any money," and went on about his business. He could have just said, "I don't have any money, but get on up and walk anyway." But he didn't say that. He said, "I don't have silver and I don't have gold." He said, "But what I do have, I'll give it to you." He said, "But there's a name that you got to go through in order to have access to it." Hey, I'll preach it to myself if I have to. And one of the reasons why you've been failing at some stuff, it could be because you've been trying to do it on your own power. But the text here shows us, catch this, that the bridge from bondage to breakthrough is in the name of Jesus. I said the bridge from bondage to breakthrough is wrapped up in the name of Jesus. And I came to tell some of you, in order to break the cycle of bondage in your life, you've got to learn how to apply his name. I'm on my way back to Zunow, Virginia now, Donald, but I feel like preaching a little while. The other day, I was watching a movie about a superhero by the name of Shazam. And in this movie, there was a little boy named Billy that one day happened to walk into a cave. And in the cave, he stumbled across an ancient man named Shazam. Shazam was sitting on a throne, and Shazam caught his eye. He looked at the little boy and he said, "I'm choosing you to be my champion." And he said, "But you have to say my name so that my power can flow through you." And the little boy looked at him and he said he felt unsure about it. And the ancient man looked at him and said, "If you carry my name, you'll be able to carry my power." And when the boy said the name Shazam, he then transformed from being a mediocre little boy into being a superhero that ended up changing the world. And I came to let somebody know this morning, if I can preach for just a little while, that if you carry his name, you'll be able to carry his power. Some trust in horses, some trust in chariots, but we, the people of God, Donald, will put our trust in the name of the Lord. Come on, give me all you got. For the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous can run therein, and they are safe. I came to let you know this morning that if you apply his name, you'll have everything that you need. If you apply his name, you need. There was a song we used to sing a while ago, that there's something about the name Jesus. But I came to let you know this morning that we don't have to sing that anymore, because we know what's in the name of Jesus. Everything is in the name of Jesus. Power in the name of Jesus. Healing in the name of Jesus. Deliverance in the name of Jesus. Tell me who can stand before us when we call on that great name. His name is Jesus. You ought to type Jesus. Precious Jesus, we have the victory. We have the victory. We have the victory. me. It's because his name is on your life. You ought to give somebody a virtual high five and say, his name is on me. His name is on me. His name is on my life. That's why I'm free, because his name is on my life. Because whom the Son set free is truly free indeed. I don't know about you this morning, but I came to let you know that everything you need is in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. But listen, I stopped reading at verse 6, and I'm almost out of here, I promise. Stop reading at verse 6, where he said, rise up and walk. But as our pastor said, we believe in prayer. We believe in the power of Jesus Christ. But something happened in the text that jumped out to me. It said, then Peter reached down and he helped the man up. Now, what I like to look at is the response of the man. Because the text says that after he took the man's hand, strength immediately came into his legs and he was able to walk. But there's something special to me about the man's response. Because the man had never walked before. He had never done it on his own. He could never even begin to know what it's like to sit in a chair and to be able to jump up. So this man could have very well said, no, I'm not going to even try. I'm going to stay here and do what I've always been doing. But when Peter reached down, some versions say the man grabbed him and instantly he stood up and strength came back into his legs. I believe in prayer. I believe in the power of the name of Jesus. But sometimes it takes initiative on our part to be able to break the cycle. You got to have a made up mind that I am going to come out of this thing. No matter the cost, no matter what it looks like, you got to make up in your mind that guess what? It doesn't matter how long I've been here. It doesn't matter how dark the day has been. I'm going to come out of this thing on top. I'm determined to break this curse. I'm determined to break this cycle. I'm determined to dismantle every plot and plan the enemy has set for me. So not only was there power in his name, but once he realized he had the opportunity to receive something different, he seized the moment. And I come to encourage you all that this is your season that's watching. This is your season of breakthrough. This is your season where something different is knocking on your doorstep. Will you seize the moment? Will you seize the opportunity to break free of the bondage of the yoke that's around your neck? I don't know what it is. It might be any generational curse, alcoholism, drug. I don't care what it is, but there is nothing too hard for God in your life. All you have to do is seize the moment, seize the opportunity to say, this is my time. This is my day. This is my season that the cycle, the habit, the bondage, the yoke is going to be broken. If you're listening and you're watching and you know that this message spoke to you and you know you don't know Jesus Christ in the pardon of your sins, just as the Apostle Peter reached his hand down to pick that lame man up, I come to let you know this morning that the hand of God is reaching out to you. Ah, glory be to God. I said the hand of God is reaching out to you. And all you have to do is grab it. He says, I stand at the door of your heart and I knock.
because Jesus is a gentleman. All you have to do is let him in. If you want to know him in the pardon of your sins, if you need freedom and deliverance, prayer and breakthrough from any cycle and bondage or dysfunction that's in your life, I dare you to pick up your phone, your smartphone now, and you can text LIVEGC to the number 313131. That's LIVEGC to the number 313131. And one of our ministers will be there, and they will respond to you. They will minister deliverance to you, and they will let you know that freedom is available to you. Let's pray for a moment. Our Father and our God, we thank you for the opportunity to be able to hear that we can get back on our feet. The God in whom the Son has set free is truly free indeed. God, I thank you that just as this lame man had the opportunity to break free of him, of his cycles, God, we have that same opportunity. That there's no chain too great that your power can't break it. We give you praise and we give you glory and we give you honor for the seed that this word was to the hearts of your people. That it was planted, hey, glory, thank you, that it was planted in fertile ground. No, Father, it's up to you to do the increase. We give you praise and we give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for joining us for today's message. If God is impacting your life through this ministry, join us in reaching others all over the world by investing today. You can give at grovechurchva.com/giving. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more messages like this one.